Hey, scientist! Zeke is finally here visiting Earth, and I need your help explaining something to him. He is so confused because yesterday was a clear, sunny, warm day, but today it is a rainy, windy, and even a little chilly outside. I guess I can understand why he is feeling confused, considering planet Zug doesn't have changing weather. Apparently, planet Zug is warm, clear, and sunny every day. Must be nice. Since he will be here for another week, it looks like we need to teach him about the different kinds of weather he can expect here on Earth. But, why does weather change? Let's find out. Before we can figure out why the weather changes, we have to understand what weather is. Weather is what the sky and air around us is like at any given time. When we talk about the weather, we consider many different parts or elements. Let's look out my window and see what we can observe about the weather today.
I don't know.
I know, Zeke. You aren't used to the rain, but let's talk about it. Rain is a type of precipitation, which is a scientific name for water that falls from the sky. Can you think of any other kind of water that falls from the sky? Exactly. Snow and hail are two other kinds of precipitation. All precipitation comes from clouds, which is why we can see many dark gray rain clouds in our sky today. Hey, I just mentioned another element of weather, cloudiness. Cloudiness is the amount of clouds covering the sky. There are four categories of cloudiness. Clear, which means there are barely any clouds in the sky. Partly cloudy, which means there are a few clouds. Cloudy, which means the sky is mostly covered with clouds. And overcast, which means the sky is completely covered in clouds. Looking out the window today, we are definitely overcast. What is the cloudiness like where you are today? When you look at the sky on a cloudy day, you may see many different kinds of clouds. Different types of clouds indicate different types of weather. When you see dark gray clouds, like the clouds outside our window, that is a sign that you might have some precipitation ahead. Do you hear that? Another element of weather, the wind. Wind is air moving across Earth's surface. You can't actually see the wind, but you can see it moving things around, like tree branches or wind chimes. When the wind is really blowing, like it is today, it can sometimes lower the temperature outside. That reminds me, we have one final element of weather to look for. To check the final element of weather, we need a special scientific tool. Do you remember what the name of this tool is? Good job! A thermometer. A thermometer measures the temperature, which, when we are talking about weather, is the amount of heat in the air. No, Zeke, I am not going to make you go outside. Don't worry. We have a weather station nearby, so I can check the current temperature online. According to our local weather station, the current temperature is a little bit chilly right now. This temperature seems much cooler than yesterday's. I am so glad we are staying warm and dry inside today. Now that we have a better understanding of today's weather, let's compare it to yesterday's weather. There were some big changes. Yesterday, there was no precipitation, and the sky was only partly cloudy. There was a gentle breeze, and the temperature was much warmer. 11 degrees warmer, to be exact. How did the weather go from this to this so quickly? Well, in order to understand why the weather changes, it is important to understand where the weather happens. Earth has something called an atmosphere, which is like a big blanket of air that covers Earth's surface. The atmosphere is where all of our weather happens. It is where we live, too. In our atmosphere, clouds, precipitation, wind, and temperature mix together to create different kinds of weather. Our atmosphere is constantly moving and changing, which is what causes the changes in our weather. Some of the changes happen slowly, and some of the changes happen super quickly. Aha! I think I've got it. If our atmosphere is the cause of our changing weather on Earth, and planet Zug doesn't have any changing weather, what must planet Zug be missing? Exactly. Planet Zug must not have an atmosphere. Now, Zeke has been feeling pretty down today with this rainy weather, so I wanted to show him something that just might cheer him up. On Earth, we have scientists called meteorologists. Meteorologists study Earth's atmosphere to understand and predict the weather. By studying the elements of weather like temperature, precipitation, cloudiness, and wind, meteorologists are able to predict changes in weather many days ahead of time. For example, meteorologists can determine where a storm is going next based on how it is moving in the atmosphere. Once they can find out which direction it is moving, they can predict which area will have rainy days next. That's right, Zeke. This storm won't be here forever. Remember, the atmosphere is always moving and changing, which means our weather is too. Now, without further ado, behold our weather forecast. This forecast is a prediction of the weather ahead. Based on the meteorologist's forecast, it doesn't look like we will have any more rain during your visit. That's great news. But the weather doesn't change that fast. Zeke, I think we'll have to wait until tomorrow to go to the pool. Thanks for your help today, scientist. And remember, science is all around you. Hey, hey.